Hey guys, it's YourBrokerBears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 PSV mode. Oops, continue. Hang on. After winning the league, now the focus turns primarily to the Champions League. And after her getting passed around Madrid, I'm rewarded with another giant team. The old lady, Juventus. Italian Giants, the multi-time Italian champions. And probably the best team in Italy. No offense to other teams, but if Juventus weren't the best team in Italy, they wouldn't constantly win. They wouldn't be constantly winning the title. That'd be like saying Bayern Munich aren't the best team in Germany.
To actually lift some silverware. We're in the quarterfinals, Alan.
Yeah, when you get to this stage, you can start to smell the final, can't you?
True, there'd be some competition. Now, granted, the Serie A can be closer than the Bundesliga at times, but no. And to still win the league. I think they won five or six in a row now in real life.
In Gonzalo Higuain.
His ability on the ball is second to none, Martin, and his teammates will be anxious to feed him that ball as much as they can.
Well, definitely a step in the right direction for Juventus.
Not the easiest reward after beating Real Madrid, but there's no such thing as an easy path.
Start to the game. It's certainly a foul, but the referee's kept his cards in his pocket. A timely challenge, and the cross comes in now. Well, the cross looked good, but it didn't turn out.
All I can do is get a nice big victory here in the first leg. That'll set me up nicely for the second leg, but. This is easier said than done.
Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle. Sami Khedira.
Proper.
It's looking good this
week. Yes, I am putting out the main team because now that the league is good. And this is my main focus.
A great start for them. A wonderful goal.
I'm sure a lot of you will say, what about the Dutch Cup? Well,
managers approach to this game.
I do want to focus on that as well, but there's only one game left there. That's the final.
I love that kind of finish when you don't have to blast it as long as the placement is right.
So I'm not too worried about playing out the main team here, especially because the next game is actually the second game in this episode is a league game against Ajax, which normally I would just sim. But I have this run of getting perfect league records without losing a game going. And I want to earn it. And by simming a game and possibly losing
it.
Because I'll be using the second game. Let's face it, I don't know if they're ready to beat Ajax.
And the assistant, of course, has one chance to see it.
They're ready for that.
Oh, just about. I mean, that is a great call from the official over there. There wasn't much in it, a few inches really.
Crisp defending there. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Great tackle. Slot me right where I... He would have... Nice. Ferreira.
Well, they gave it straight to him, didn't they?
Cuadrado. They've got the ball back by that interception.
Yeah.
Not a good challenge by the... The shot's on!
2-0! Fantastic. This is going beautifully.
They'll feel a little bit more comfortable. And they're good value for this advantage at the moment. Speed.
just get three or four more goals and there'll be absolutely no doubt that I will be in the semi-final of the Champions League.
Restarting at 2-0.
We'll be, those are going to be scoring the first goal. If they score it, won't
be. Lichtsteiner. Cuadrado. Isimat Mirin.
Has two of them.
Onto the attack now.
I'm not sure if Ed, if my center back, who I signed from Mönchengladbach, I don't know if he played any games with Mönchengladbach.
Gonzalo Higuain.
In this competition, I didn't actually check that.
Counter-attack.
He'd be on one of the previous appearances.
And he's put it away. Well, it's a fine individual counter-attack.
3-0.
What a goal from him. Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and he took it in excellent style, just like the first one.
Well, it's a he's back in Italy for the first time. Of course, it's not his club I bought him off. Off it's Juventus, who he has no
comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
Playing them as AC Milan and then Roma.
Javi Martinez. Dybala. Good challenge. Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to actually use today.
Unfortunately, I don't think Roma or AC Milan
started with. Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping a bit more.
Semi-bad for the past.
I mean, they have to change halfway through this match.
This season, they're spending their money and not giving a shit who
Dybala. A lot of
comes after them.
This
is the approach I am imploring Liverpool to do.
And in goes the cross.
If it brings success,
actually, it's just Peter.
They say, "Hey, we'll fucking take a transfer ban or
occasions getting the better of
fucking whatever."
A bit more so far.
We're here to get to make.
He's got to do better. Otherwise, what's the point in having him out
success.
There?
Juventus with the greater share of possession. There's no surprise in that. PSV have a free kick here. David Prepa. Doing well to keep the ball. Very good tackle. And the added time will amount to 3 minutes at least. Chiellini's challenge, excellent. And here's the shot.
Ooh.
And turned it aside. Still on the attack, and they've got a corner. Looking for an opening.
Guerrero.
Control builder. Good work from the keeper.
Ah, Buffon. Man uses his legs.
A corner. It's Gigi Buffon.
Well there.
Still a master of his craft.
He's a master at getting his angles right, isn't he, this goalkeeper?
Very well timed tackle. Great start here for the team.
3-0 half time. It's not bad, not bad, not bad. I'll take it because it gives me the opportunity to extend that lead in the second half.
Good first half, hoping for something better in the second half. The second half now underway of this Champions Cup quarter final.
Yeah, it got a little bit cagey at times in the first half, but it might open up as the match wears on.
He went in well.
If I start to say, have a chance.
Building steadily here, keeping possession.
I'm actually
Cuadrado. Well, that looked promising. but he's been stopped.
Despite having a chance to make that change.
That's a penalty.
Thank you, a penalty. Thank you, Benucci. Oh, he's gone!
Yes.
Similar to Sergio Ramos, as Benucci is the center back who goes bye-bye this time. Now Juventus are in the same boat Real Madrid were in their first leg against me. Yeah, clipped Oshereri as the one was sent away. Oshereri will step up, and he'll score.
That's a pretty good penalty with the pressure on.
Yeah, I mean, this boy is a composed penalty taker, and he showed it there. Really, really cool.
Buffon rooted to the spot. Get in. Two? Wait, two?
Turning out to be a comfortable game, this 4-0. Well, this is a real shock. You can see it in the faces of the players, and you can hear it in the lack of noise, if you like, from the supporters.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to...
That's a free kick awarded here.
When did he score the first? I've been playing this. But it seems I have absolutely no idea when that first Oshereri goal came. I don't think too much of it.
Khedira. There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team.
I know I used my second team against
Asamoah. Probing away, trying to find room for a shot.
Maybe
you can see what he was trying to do, just stretch the opposition by getting the ball out wide, but it's gone out for a throw. I think some people thought it was a gamble to play him from the start and to go with a wide man. Well, the manager got it right, didn't he?
Well, didn't he just? His teammates, you could see in the early stages, just kept feeding the ball to him because they know he's the man on song at the moment.
I have to go back and watch my previous 18 episodes. I have absolutely no idea when he threw that goal. It might have been the second leg against Real Madrid. That's one
tackle. He's got his tackle in, and the ball's gone out now.
Well, unless he got a goal in like the qualifiers for Roma.
Impatience as they try to get an opening.
Which I guess technically counts.
Getting into attacking positions.
Did he do that? I signed him pretty early.
Prepper.
He was a priority for me.
Khedira.
Because I needed that extra bit of pace on that side.
Well, they've got to curb this, Alan, haven't they? He's only got a yellow this time, but it's wild out there.
I'm just looking.
You want to be careful. Well, next time. Juventus will have no players left. That's the way they're going.
Go a bit more careful now.
Benucci got a straight red card. Erden, get it.
Very good defending.
Rezna, a walking
El Shaarawy.
Ever so famous tightrope.
Good forward play from them.
Well, Chiellini will hate that, to get beat in that manner.
The shot's on! Well, he lost his foot.
How did you miss that, Stefan?
It's a slippery old surface down there, and you've got to get your feet sorted out properly.
Go into the box. All they had to do was score, and nope. Well, they won't be around long enough to try and to face the possibility of maybe getting dismissed by the referee. I guess the, is it a leg break?
Way to nick the ball back. Quick thinking.
I'm trying to think of who the Juventus manager is. I think it's... Isn't it a leg break? His name is a leg
break. To it.
I'm not sure what his first name is. which shows you the circumstances. I know about the you've got the extra play. Italian league.
Yeah, they've used the full width of the pitch to
something Allegri.
Completed team. Replay confirming think. For us here that the goalkeeper did get a touch, but not strong enough to keep the ball out of his net. Well, he is his own harshest critic. This
anyway,
blame himself for that. I think having got a touch.
Anyway, and now it's he obviously. And you know what? I'm not going to take any chances.
5-0 and the game underway again.
Wait, why did he bring off Javi Martinez? I mean, you could slot Javi Martinez into the centre back slot position, that's missing now that well. Since Benucci was position now. Dismissed. I know he's primarily a defender, but he's also a centre back.
And he could
in fact, I think
here.
He's a centre back in this game. That's his main position.
Up for grabs here.
In fact, I'm almost certain it's his main position. So,
well, they're building steadily and working away.
He took off. Now, maybe they were playing him in.
The goalkeeper comes out with a punch.
That they replaced him with midfielder, or else they just don't give a shit. Because
he's got that.
Now, who's back there? Who's at center back? Because Chiellini, what's he doing? Where the fuck is he going? You're 5-0 down, and you move 10 men, and you're running up the pitch.
And the goalkeeper got a touch to that.
Yeah,
fine
that's
save.
A smart move there.
Shoots.
6-0. Thank you very much. Maybe if your defenders didn't go walkabouts, Juventus, I'd have someone there to stop me. I mean, Alexandro.
He's been a thorn in the side.
He tried, I guess.
He thoroughly deserves that hat trick.
I mean, he ran alongside me. He didn't exactly tackle me.
It's 6-0 as the game is restarted.
Yeah.
Cuadrado.
I don't think anyone in this team knows how to do their job. Because Chiellini here decided to go walkabouts instead of, you know, defending. 5-0 down again when the team has 10 men.
Into the attacking third.
That makes perfect sense.
That old song, you only sing when you're winning. Well, they're winning, but they do plenty of singing when they're not.
Well, they're known for it, aren't they? And it certainly helped.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say
it spurred them on to victory.
I'm in the semi-final because Juventus are not recovering from this. No. That's 6-0 down, which means they'll have to score 7. And they'll not have Benucci for the second leg, similar to how Real Madrid did not have Ramos.
Only one team in the contest.
In the previous
the final whistle, and they finished 6-0 winners.
Good centre back seem to get sent off against me. I don't know what it is.
And they are now set up for that second leg, which they hope will lead.
Buffon, not the best day at the office for him.
All about concert.
Locadia gets another hat trick because, yeah, why the hell not? Napoli take a 2-1 lead into their second leg against Dortmund, but that's not exactly a big lead. It's really an open game for them. I won't change it just yet. I may as well sim that game against Juventus in before I end this episode, because why the hell not? Am I right? Oh, he's not. Did I play my second team against? Did I? I mustn't have, because that. When did Al Shaarawy score that goal? I thought that was. Sorry for this little delay, it's actually going to annoy me. It was his first game. It was his first game. First game. Oh, so he didn't play any games with Mönchengladbach, fair enough. First game. Van Ginkel played 2 games. Remsar played 2 games. Oshirari has played 3? What? He's played 3! Oh. What? How is that possible? Remsar has been here the whole season, so I must have played him like a substitute or something. Would make sense. He was on... Actually... No, wait. His goal in the game against Juventus was his first. I was going to say that I think I remember him scoring in a game, but I think that was actually a cup game. And so that at least makes sense. He was on my bench. And Van Ginkel, I think he was on my bench as well. But I then replaced him with Guardado because I wanted to use the youngsters. Oshirari, was he on? He must have been on my bench for earlier Champions League games. How else could he have 3? Unless he did play E2 qualifiers with Roma, but in this game, since I set up the Champions League at the start, there were no qualifiers. So he must have put. I must have used him as a substitute. I mean, it's annoying the hell out of me. I have no idea what the hell's going on. Which, isn't exactly a good thing, is it? Let's get into this game with it.
Hi there, everyone. Martin Tyler here with you.
Ajax.
Alan Smith's alongside me, and we've got action today from the Dutch First Division.
Or Ajax, however you say it.
To be here.
PSV Eindhoven today against Ajax.
You know, when I was smaller, I always misspelled Ajax because I always thought they were. It was I, then the word axe, AXE.
Ajax have started the game.
It was only a few years later. Or I saw them playing and I saw how it's spelled. I was like,
this is how they'll play.
Who
today.
Is this team? And someone said to me, that's Ajax.
4-3-3.
Yeah, it's a system that the Netherlands used to use.
Is that how it's spelled? That's Ajax. That's not Ajax.
Since if it works, it's really tough to have.
I mean, maybe it's Ajax. Maybe that's how it's pronounced in Holland, but.
Natural wide.
I'm sorry, it's Ajax in English. This is the same problem I have with people giving an Emery he can and pronouncing his name wrong. I don't care what. If it's pronounced with a H in Germany, that's fine, but he doesn't play in Germany anymore. He plays in England where C-A-N spells can. Like a can of Coke or a can of alcoholic beverage for those of you who drink. Alcoholic beverages? What the fuck is a beverage? I don't know. Beverage. There we go. You're not lying. It's weird to me. And no one corrected me on it.
Watch the champions. With the title already sealed, nice and relaxed.
Oh yeah, just the perfect scenario for these boys. They've already been out celebrating, so it might not be the best performance here.
And since I was saying Ajax, no one ever thought, oh, is he saying that wrong? Because that's what they're called. They're called Ajax. Even though it's... I don't know.
All the cards here, it seems. Especially the points that they got for winning the away game on the ground of the opposition here.
It's something that always
up as well as they did.
Been a mystery to me why they're called Ajax when it's
attacking well here.
AZ. I mean, not AZ, AJ.
In goes the tackle, and it's
a completely different word. AZ is a different touch team, Corey. Wake up.
The shot's up. Good work by the goalkeeper.
AJ. Like, can you imagine being an English tourist and
Ajax onto the attack again?
Saying, I'm looking for an axe.
Possession changes feet.
Like, if they don't understand you, they might think, they might hear Ajax and think you're looking for the team. Or the stadium.
To keep it going today.
Well, you look throughout the side and it's full of top class performance and full of players just exuding confidence.
Looking good, this move. Great play from the attacker.
I would hope that J A E X is not how you spell an axe.
That's neatly done.
In Dutch. Maybe it is. Control, I don't know. Though.
That was a good idea to try and use the width on the pitch, but it's gone out for a throw. Good position here. Got the tackle in. And in goes the cross. And it's the goalkeeper's ball, quite clearly a wasted cross. Traore. They are the league leaders, Alan. Like league leaders.
Yeah, they are. They've got the swagger about them, haven't they, Martin?
For those of you who I know, some of you are probably thinking, oh, you make this.
He might be true.
I don't. I really don't. I really thought it was spelled I.
Caught under no challenge by the goalkeeper.
A-X-E. Years by. Like, until I was like 7 or something. So one day someone said to me,
moving forward with some danger to the opposition now to hit.
And to this day, I will remember me asking, well, why are they called Ajax when it's A-J-A-X? He almost said Z again. A-J-A-X. That's Ajax. That's Ajax.
It's
not even Ajax.
Spectacular save.
Ajax.
Not turning the ball around, he's hung on to it. Well, we're halfway through, and we haven't yet got a goal to bring to.
That's how you actually, that's actually what it says. It's Ajax, not Ajax.
Change of ends, and the second half is underway. Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it. Larsen. Corner kick given.
And I remember them saying, not sure. Maybe that's how it's pronounced in Dutch. So, you know, that's fair enough, but when they're playing on when the English commentators look at that and they're saying Ajax, do you think they're not saying to themselves, that's not how it's spelled? It says Ajax. Do you think saying that? Another guy. And I'm like, you sure? It's out of line. A J A.
Good one.
Where's E? Axe.
Good interception.
You know, strange things like that.
For the cameras, really,
the stuff that.
And the ball stays in his gloves.
The associate.
The point where the strikers feel they're not going to be able to score.
My life.
This keeper is in inspired form.
Why? I have absolutely no idea.
time for the substitutes, I think, and the substitution for the home team here. Ref could have stopped it, but he lets it go, and Ajax is delighted with him for that. We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left.
But something that did bother me for years,
tackle in.
And I, to this day, I still don't know why they're called Ajax. Now, to any Dutch people watching me, if there are any, I understand if it if they're called Ajax,
Ajax
in Dutch, if that's how it's pronounced in Dutch, that's fine. But in English, that's Ajax. I'm sorry, there's no reason for the English commentators not to say Ajax or something like that, because that is not.
I'm in with a challenge. Strong, fair challenge pulls out for
Ajax would not be right in English.
Take the lead.
Now maybe they say Ajax so they don't offend anyone. But
think they could beat this keeper between the sticks.
If I were a commentator, I would call them Ajax. And if someone said to me, that's not their name, why is it spelled that way? They would have no retort. Yes, this, that might not be the correct pronunciation of their name, but it's, I didn't call
them. By the goalkeeper.
It's not like I call them
count rising.
Shite crap or some bad
effort on goal.
I technically called them their name.
What we've had so far in terms of corners.
I looked at the name. I see he an A. I see a J. I see another A, and I see an X. I don't see an I. I'm not gonna call. I wouldn't call him Ajax.
He's coming forward with some danger.
I can just imagine if I were over in Holland. I said to someone, I'm looking for the Ajax Stadium. Ajax Stadium? They'd be like, who the fuck is Ajax?
Alan with a home team.
Now, maybe they know who I was talking about.
The away fans getting a bit restless.
I hope they would.
Very good stop here.
The most successful team in the winning the lead.
It's mate and got it back again.
That would only make them 23. Ajax are still 10 ahead.
Into the attacking third.
33. With their last one.
Put them in front. Hit the post. You can see what he was trying to do. Just stretch the opposition by getting the ball out wide, but it's gone out for a throw. And the cross is in.
De Jong! Are you fucking kidding me? There we go.
Well, they've got their noses in front, right at the end here.
Well, the supporters are going absolutely nuts. They can't believe it.
After all that.
Looking good.
A last minute header from
this goal. Talk about luck. The keeper makes it.
And some young kid wins me the match.
Well, a very exciting climax to an exciting game. This could be the decider.
Well, it could be at this stage of the match. There doesn't seem much of an opportunity to come back.
I won.
Traore. Stopped emphatically and just as well.
There's the full-time whistle. As if to rub salt into that freshly opened wound. Of conceding that very late goal.
Yeah, I know what it feels like. Winning is a wonderful habit.
Well, the referee's like, yeah, it's over.
Understand the meaning of defeat.
I think he was the best performer in a good team today.
Anyone else?
And snatch that.
How did the Ajax keeper get down the air in the pit so quickly? fastest keeper in the world. Andre Onana? I'm probably butchering his name as well, because why the fuck not at this point? He didn't go full-time whistle goes, he's up the other end of the pitch for some reason. Like, if Ajax or Ajax had a corner at the end of the game, you'd understand why he'd be up there. But they didn't. Just a bit weird that he suddenly fucking teleported up the pitch. I'm gonna consider it weird. No, I understand him wanting to go. Maybe have a chat with my goalkeeper, which is perfectly fine. He has every right to do that. They're fellow goalkeepers, fellow professionals. He's probably going to him saying, "You had nothing to do all day, and I had everything to do all day." Probably he's going to have a great big laugh together. Why the hell not? At that bullshit, I think it's more than that. But, at least show him running towards the direction of my goalkeeper, not have him instantly be there. So Juventus beat me 2-0 in the return of the egg, but Lugged, that didn't do them. This Steiner and Dybala. If you look down at least scores, do you see Dortmund beat Napoli 2-1? That means it's going to extra time. Yay! That's fun. Who won it? Because they both be on 3 goals and they both have 2 away goals, so... why am I being offered the Scotland job? Why? Anyway, I'll have this game in the next episode as well as the game against AZ, weirdly enough, considering I pretty much mentioned them in this, I did mention them in this episode. Anyway, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed, smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.